LBC News time, it's 8 minutes to nine, Saturday morning. Hello, welcome along to breakfast. I'm Nick Qureshi. Let's talk a little about one of the announcements from yesterday's Downing Street briefing. In short, this government statement of Jet Zero, which appears to be a new scheme to promote green economic growth after the coronavirus crisis, to do with aviation. We can get reaction from Geraldine Nicholson from Stop Heathrow Expansion. So, in a nutshell, good idea or not?
I think it's a very good idea. It really should be the way forward of working out how we can have aviation after the coronavirus and how it goes forward. So, yeah, a good idea.
It's a bit strange announcing it now when hardly anything's flying.
It is a bit strange, but if you think about it, Nick, this is probably the best time to start planning. While we don't have that huge number of flights going across the sky, this is probably the best time to work out how we get it restarted, but we get it restarted where it's not going to be as detrimental as it was before.
Yeah, but some would say that the priority should be getting aviation moving now.
Some people will say that. Yes, aviation is very important to the economy, but the damage it was doing to the environment, we have a net zero target by 2050. We were never going to reach that until this pandemic when it shut everything down. So, we need to kickstart aviation, but we need to do it in an environmentally sustainable way.
You must be quite relieved there's not many planes above your skies.
I've got to admit, it's actually been quite lovely. We've used this opportunity to relax in gardens, listen to birds, things like that. People have been able to sleep for the first time in years. So I won't say that I haven't missed it. It has been a really peaceful and really lovely. But, as I said, aviation is important to the economy. It just cannot be. We can't go back to pre-pandemic levels.
Nevertheless, there is going to be more traffic in, well, whenever. So, once again, people are going to have to cope with that.
People will have to cope, but if you look at things, look how we've adapted in like three very short months. People are, for want of a better word, zooming, and that seems to work for businesses, so... we've got to look forward. Will the demand actually be there? I don't think it will. I think that companies now finding better ways, cheaper ways of working, and the demand's not going to be there. So this is the ideal time to look at the Jet Zero.
Who's going to be involved in getting this scheme off the ground, as it were?
Well, I'm hoping that it's going to be environmental groups like the Aviation Environment Federation. They work with local groups and they've been involved in trying to make it greener for years and years and years. So it'd be really good to see them involved. People like Greenpeace, they should be involved as well. Obviously, they're environmental campaigners, they know what they're doing, they know what they're talking about. Anybody, it mustn't just be people from the industry.
Who's going to be paying for this all?
Well, the government announced it, so I expect the government will be paying for it all, ultimately.
Us.
But, we'll end up paying for it if we don't get it right anyway through climate change. And it's not just climate change with the net zero. It's the impact it has on local air quality and things like that. I mean, we have discovered, we've done a study ourselves, and we discovered just in Heathrow area that air quality has improved by over 40% since planes stopped flying.
Oh, I mean, why has this been announced now? I mean, the emphasis hasn't it, on cleaner, greener air for years. So why now?
Because the cleaner, greener air for years has just been that talked about. And I think now is the time to do something, and it looks like the government has seen that, this is one way to really start doing something about it.
When is this supposed to be coming in?
when's it supposed to be coming in? Well, we need to be net zero by 2050, so they should have been working on this already. We've had promises of, you know, environmentally friendly planes for years and years and years, but going back to the start of the coronavirus pandemic, that they were dropping their ideas for things like electric aircraft, and, you know, now that is more and more years and years away, and what we're going to do, just talk about it again for years and years and years. I'm hoping this Jet Zero just isn't going to become a talking shop.
All right, a fair enough point to leave it. Geraldine Nicholson from Stop Heathrow Expansion. Many thanks indeed for your time. This.